business and our lives. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let's stretch out our hand to the minister that just left here. Let's pray that the grace to become better in all his aspirations, God grant unto him. Let's pray for the people that have come before him, the worship session, the open levels, the in, that the grace to become better anytime they stand for him, God will grant unto them. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you are glad that Jesus has risen, he's no more in the grave. Rise to your feet and shout hallelujah. Open your mouth and begin to bless him, appreciate him, thank him for the sacrifice that he made with his life. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, in any way I will be standing before you, unrighteous, please have mercy on me. Cleanse me with the blood of Jesus and make me whole and holy. In any way I may be standing before you, unrighteous, have mercy on me. Make me whole and holy. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You deserve for the sacrifice you have paid. You deserve the lifting of our hands. You deserve. the one that was, the one that is, the one that is to come, the ancient of days, my helper, my healer, my fortress, the one that has favored me, the one that has lifted me. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
On this kind of day, many years ago, where they had already put him in the tomb, the women got there. They saw that the stone had been rolled away and an angel was sitting on it. The angel was sitting on it as if to say, let me see whose father will come and roll this stone back. In the deliverance that you have gotten, nothing will be able to keep those things back into your life.
Amen.
Open your life mouth and can say, Father, in all that you have delivered me from, generational curses, every form of evil covenant, every bad habit, make it impossible for me to be recaptured by them as you did for Jesus. The stone was rolled away, I got not rolled back. Make it impossible. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. There is an anointing called exceptional anointing. Meaning that it may be happening to everybody, negative thing, it will not happen to me. If you read the book of Job chapter 1, we don't have time. Each person that came to deliver the bad news to Job, we see that we were all there, plenty of us. All of a sudden, fire fell and destroyed all. Only I only have escaped to tell you. Another one will come. Your children and everybody, they were gathered, and all of a sudden, the band of something came and destroyed. Only I and I alone have escaped. That is an anointing for exception. They may be resisting other people in the area that you desire something. When it gets to your own time, the door will be open.
Yeah.
Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, anointing for exceptional miracles and blessings. Release unto me right now. In the name of Jesus. What kill others will not kill me. What trap others will not trap me. Where others give up, I will not give up. Anointing for exceptional. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. When you read the book of Job, so many things there. Job was talking to God, and Satan was talking to God. And is it not because you have built an edge around about him? So it is possible for edge to be built around about a child of God. Open your mouth and say, Father, build your edge of protection around about me, and let it never be broken. Help me, and let it never be broken. Your edge of protection. So whether I'm in the air, on the land, on the sea, I am safe. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. From that book of Job, we also realize that devil cannot do anything against the child of God except the Lord gives him permission. Don't be fooled. God is still in control, regardless of how things may be in any nation. It is when he gives permission, and sometimes he gives permission towards the child of God from the devil, when he knows what that child of God is made of. He has built so much strength, you know, in design, architectural and structural design. The architect design and the structural design building to carry the weight or the load that will eventually come up the building. So they are not scared if you want to do party on the upper floor and you bring so many people there. You may be scared that all the time, all these 45 years that we have been living in this building, they have never brought this kind of, what if this building we could collapse. They have designed everything to accommodate it. God sometimes has designed so many things to accommodate. The Bible said that they will not allow what is beyond your strength to come upon you. So if you have any challenge, you have more than what it takes in you to handle it and to overcome it. Many times, because you are not aware, we will be scared. I believe that that happened to be one of the undoing of Moses. Sometimes challenges overwhelm us. I will start making some careless statement. I am tired, not like Elijah. I want to give up. Whereas we have all it takes to handle that thing and see triumph. Moses was telling God, am I the one that gave birth to all this? Leave me, let me bring other people to come and help me. And guess what God did? He did not agree with it. He gathered 70 elders. I think Numbers chapter 11, 25. And the Bible said that out of the spirit inside of Moses, I was not wondering how much loaded this guy was. He put inside 70. Not everything, no. Out of the spirit in Moses, he put inside 70 elders. And the Bible said that they just had that prophesy, they could not control themselves until the end of the day. I said, this is what this guy has been carrying, but he did not know what he carried. Okay, and the Lord came down in a cloud and spake unto him and took of the spirit that was upon him and gave it unto the 70 elders. And it came to pass that when the spirit rested upon them, they prophesied and did not, they could not control themselves again. And this was what this guy was carrying. They were saying, I'm not able to. You are loaded, more than the challenge that you are going through, loaded inside of you, the resources of heaven, to handle and to overcome it. You know why I said that? That could be one of his undoing. Something has been removed from him, and some virtue has also come out from him. Hence, the person that was interceding for the people, he now started abusing them. When temptation came, he could not resist temptation. He started disobeying God. Speak to the Lord. He started. I was now wondering, what if they have not removed? Maybe part of what had been removed could have helped him to be more stable and to bear it. In your moment of trial, be careful not to make careless statements that will take something off you that you will need to handle the situation. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, grant unto me wisdom. Open my eyes to see all you have made me to be. In the name of Jesus, because God has made it to be in charge and to be above whatever challenge may be coming your way. Open my eyes. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. One mommy came to us, I think last week. I think after any few hours, Wednesday or so, and she came to us that our aunt in the UK, London to be precise, but I've been working there for over 15 years, will soon be retired, but somebody had been giving her issue. And they're even threatening that they're going to take her out of that place, give to another place, and she's no wonder. Then she will soon get to the end of her service, maybe she will not require and they'll be paying her or something. And she called her in my presence, said, Pastor, just help me to talk to her and pray for her. And she told me everything. The pastor, this person gave me, because maybe she happened to be the child of, because of her color. I was the one that put her through the job, a younger fellow, 2 years ago when she joined. But now she just giving me, she was telling this one, write petition, do everything. They are coming for different panel. So please help me to pray. I told her that it's not actually her. It's his spirit trying to discredit you at the tail end of your service there. It's that spirit that we are going to be dealing with. Then we pray for her and send some prayer to her. It was this morning when I woke up and I was doing some other thing, and I said, son, that she has even sent a chat to me on Friday. I've been so busy. And I read it that, Pastor, so, glory be to God, blah, 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 that this morning when I resume work on Friday, our senior manager sent for me and said that they are going to be removing that lady.
Hallelujah.
He said that she now said, thank God for answered prayers. Anyone that is against your life, anywhere that person is, shall be removed. Because the Bible said that he will contend with those, not God. Isaiah 49:25, open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, according to your word, contend with my contender, and God will give me victory over them. Contend with my contender, and grant unto me victory over them. Contend with my contender, and grant me victory over them. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Yesterday, in the course of the first services, a sister just rushed to my office. You know, she was just saying, I was trying to prepare, and you know, I didn't know. She just rushed. She just said, Pastor, I just want to tell you something. I said, what is the matter? And she just started, she gave me a report, doctor's report, that she had entered menopause. And this ought not to be. But that was the report. And she said that she was trying to see me, but somehow she could not see me, and she now came to the altar. And she now said that you are the God of Pastor Tunks. And you are my God. Please attend to this. He said, Pastor, this morning, that was yesterday, I saw the sign of but what they are trying to see is that on resurrection morning, that which was dead, or which enemy wanted to be dead, came alive again. Open your mouth and cry. Say, Father, anything that is dead in my life, that ought to be alive for me to rejoice. Let the power of resurrection come upon now. Everything that is dead in my life, that ought to be alive, for me to rejoice, let them come alive. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We bow down and worship. Father, will there be any of my life, my family, my aspirations? situation that I'm in disarray. By your spirit, set things in order. Maneke chukubalakata papate ibiliba. Patu malakashana. Mereke sete de 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 de. Rakata kababa. Mereke sete de baba baba baba. Yeke yebili baba. By your spirit in you, you can change the policy to favor you. Malakashana ya baba. Prayer point that we have laid down unto you. You said your house shall be called the house of prayer. Why? Because you are interested in answering prayer. Thank you for the answer to this prayer. But we also know that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above that which you can ever ask or think. Father, exceed our expectation.
Amen.
As I'm about to go briefly into your word, let your word also come into us. Let the word give us insight.
Amen.
And impact us with fresh grace.
Amen.
We that are here and our brethren that are connected online, wherever they are, Father, reach out to all of us.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
in
Lord.
Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
God bless you. Please be seated. What did they normally call Easter Monday? They not box Monday. It's just Easter Monday. Because look like Christmas is boxing. Help us. Praise the Lord. Mind your business part 92 K. 94. You people, don't be a lack of bad day. We are going to do part 2 of what we started last week. Last week we talked about some reason why employees lose their job. We told off of some reason. But because of time, we could not conclude. But because of the season of Easter, so laid in my heart to just do a little twist. We can continue that part maybe after all. I'm going to be talking of the act of management and leadership. The act of management and leadership. You know, in business or in corporate world, these two abilities, they are very essential. The people that are paid the highest, they are these two. Management and the leadership. But you need to learn the art. And the world is complaining these days of the missing link. The retiring generation, they are not adequately passing on the information that is adequate for the next generation to pick up. Or maybe the next generation that is not taking time to receive from them, but there has been a breach. There has been a break in transmission. And that is what is going on in the world presently, whether you realize it or not. Management talks about resolving issues and maintaining the tempo for the now. It's good. But leadership is talking about the future. How to carry the organization, the business, or the people that is being led in and consider the future. Hence, training is essential for leadership. And the training may not really be profiting for now, but for the time to come, because at one time the baton will be handed over, and there is no good success without a successor. When a business cannot last beyond the one that started the business, that business has failed, and the one that started it has failed. Hence, management is good. Leadership is also good. I cannot say one is better than the other. But the thing is that these days, if you want to be on top, you have to be a master of the two. You don't just be a manager. And you don't just be a leader and know nothing about management. You have to learn the art of management and leadership for you to maintain And even rise in whatever you do, whether it is church, that you are the pastor, it is the business, that you are the MD, the principle is the same everywhere. If you are a successful leader, it will manifest in the things that happen in your life. Be a good manager, because you have to, a manager must manage resources, manage situation, manage conflicts, manage process, and these are the things that happen in any organization, whether it's a spiritual organization or in the secular. If you are not able to manage it, it will show after 1 or 2 years. You will not be able to go. But for a person to take organization from one level to another and to be here on the increase, the person knows something about management and something about leadership. Very, very important. When you look at the story of Joseph and Jesus, there are so many similarities. I discovered that God was painting the picture of Jesus to Joseph. When you look at all the things that happened in the life of Joseph, it was like, you know, when you see the artist, they are painting, they say, what does this one look like? What does this one? It was through the life of Joseph was painting Jesus. Joseph was loved by the father. He gave him the coat of many colors. God loved by, and Jesus loved by God. The Bible said that the Spirit of God came upon him that day in Matthew chapter 3, verse 17. And he said, this is my beloved, in whom what? And where please, similarities. Joseph was sold by his brothers. He came to them to bring food for them from the father. They grabbed him, they sold him. And the Bible said, Jesus, John chapter 1, verse 11, he came to his home. But his own receiving what? Not. Joseph was sold for 30 pieces and for 20 pieces of silver. Genesis 37, verse 28. Jesus was sold for 30 pieces of silver. Matthew 26, verse 15. So much similarity. Joseph went to a place. By the end of his going to pray, it was not preparing a place for his brothers. Jesus Christ said that I have gone to prepare what? A place. Because I just saw that God was catching the picture of Jesus through the life of Joseph. They did not know him, but he knew them when he eventually came to them. Even though they did wrong to him, what did he do to them? He did them well. But that's just aside. I can go on and on and be picking similarities. But one thing about Joseph that made him to be in charge, he was a sound manager of situation. He was able to give sound advice of the time of plenty, reserve some, and put in the time of lack, and that was what made them to sail through. Joseph was a good manager of situation. When you are a good manager, or you must learn to be a good manager in your business, because situations will come that could may want to destabilize you. He learned how to manage when he was loved, and manage when he was not loved. Manage when he had, and manage when he did not have. Manage when they lied against him. Manage when he was favored by his leader. He has so many, but he just maintained. He did not just go up. And for your business to prosper, you must be a sound manager. Sound manager of stress. Sound manager of anger. Sound manager of bitterness. Because this stuff, they will happen to you. You have to learn how to manage. Apostle Paul said also, one of his secrets, he said, I have learned how to behave myself when I have abundance and when I have nothing. He also said, in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 22, said that to the weak, I behave as weak, so that I might gain. You have to be a good manager. And for you to be a good manager, I'll just suggest some things to you, briefly. Number one, you have to be well prepared. it's taught Pharaoh how to be prepared for the time things will not be okay. Because when you live prepared, when situation, they will not take you off guard. Be well prepared. Number two, think positively. Think positively. Regardless of what may happen to you, always think positive. Number three, be calm. Whenever there are some stressful situations that happen to you, the tendency is for you to erupt in your thinking. And when you erupt in your thinking, you will not be thinking soundly. And when you are not thinking soundly, there won't be solution at sight. Just be calm. Then make a plan. Make a plan. You have to make a plan towards how will I get, and all these things, you will see them in the life of Joseph. How you will get out of this situation. Then take action. After take action, seek help. You will not always be able to handle everything by yourself. There are some times you need spiritual help, somebody to hold your hand and agree with you. The Bible said that one will change 1,000, two will change 10,000. What if it, what is against you is about 8,000. I mean that you'll be trying with all your spiritual might, you are not able to get over it because you are not partying with somebody. It is not everybody that you'll be telling your matter to. You have to be sensitive to know who you will go to. And you see that in the life of the widow that lost the son, or not the widow, the Shunammite woman. I think it's 2 Kings chapter 4, for 25 downward. Elisha sent Gehazi, go on, is not this woman coming? Go and ask her, it's all well, it's all well. And when that one went there, he said that, is everything well? He said that, it is well. But by the time she got to the man of God, she just like the feet, said that, why did I tell you to give me a child? Why is he said, and the Elisha said that, God has hidden this thing for me. Okay, no problem, where is the child? And he went there, slept on the child, did many things, and the child woke up again. What can I learn from that? He was telling Gehazi, it is well, because I know that you, this money you like. She didn't say so, you know, but you know, it's money that you told her that you collected it. It's money you like, you are not anointing for money. I want the man of God that is sincere that. So it may not be everybody, but there will be some people that they can handle it. And I pray that every situation that you that may come your way, God will help you to manage them effectively. Yeah. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, regardless of whatever situation that will come my way, help me to manage effectively unto victory and celebration. Unto victory and celebration. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, we commit ourselves into your hand, just like Joseph and Jesus. Regardless of what people will do to us, what we will confront in life, help us to rise. And help us to manage to teach them effectively and be good leaders, even in our businesses. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let us have faith and bring up.